We're going to murder those lousy Hun bastards by the bushel.
Never show weakness. Only pain that matters, the pain you inflict.
It's the roughest and toughest show on TV, The American Gladiators.
You gotta out tough people when you get down there. You spit on man down there.
Police say boys aged 13 and 11 were arrested near the school carrying guns and wearing camouflage.
2 and 3 million American women are battered in their homes every year. More than 4,000.
Men know what our culture expects of a so-called real man. They also know very well what you get called if you don't measure up.
You get called a pussy,
a bitch.
He's a fag.
Queer. Soft.
You're a little mama's boy.
Emotional.
Girly.
He's a wimp.
Bitch.
Queer.
You get called weak.
Wuss.
Sissy.
Fag.
A fag.
Fag. You're a fag.
So for boys, and this is true for every racial and ethnic background and every socioeconomic group, to be a real man, to be tough, strong, independent, respected, means fitting into this narrow box that defines manhood. The terms that are the opposite of that, wuss, wimp, fag, sissy, are insults that are used to keep boys boxed in. So if you're a boy, it's pretty clear there's a lot of pressure on you to conform, to put up the act, to be just one of the guys. So the next question is, where do boys learn this? Obviously, they learn it in many different places. They learn from their families, their community. But one of the most important places they learn it is the powerful and pervasive media system, which provides a steady stream of images that define manhood as connected with dominance, power, and control. This is true across all racial and ethnic groups, but it's even more pronounced for men of color, because there is so little diversity of images of them to begin with in the media culture. For example, Latino men are almost always presented either as boxers, criminals, or tough guys in the barrio, and Asian American men are disproportionately portrayed as martial artists or violent criminals. But transcending race, what the media do is help to construct violent masculinity as a cultural norm. In other words, violence isn't so much a deviation as it is an accepted part of masculinity. I've worked with literally thousands of boys and men on high school, college, and professional sports teams, in the United States military, in juvenile detention centers. I've seen an awful lot of men and young men put on this tough guise. In many ways, they're putting it on as a survival mechanism. They have to do it to survive in whatever peer culture they happen to be in. But putting on the tough guise comes with a cost, and that is a cost in terms of damage to their psyches and their ability to be decent human beings. So it's in everyone's interest to examine masculinity, to pull back the curtain on the tough guy posing and see what's really going on underneath.